My name's Janine Hayes.
And I'm Ken Hills.
Well, my passion is skydiving. I was living in Queensland and we were at a national championships. And so developed a friendship, and then some years later, down the track, we got together.
My first jump was in August 1970. And I was hooked, line and sinker. Couldn't get enough of it for the next 35 years.
I wrote a poem when I was 13 about jumping out of a plane. I knew nothing about it. And I guess, I was always going to do it. So I don't know why. And it's, been everything and more.
I was going to tell myself, just find the best people there are who are the current champions and spend all your time with them. Everything that they know will rub off on you and improve.
There's been a few times. The sport can be cruel. You know, we've lost some really close friends over the years. Let's not kid ourselves. People make mistakes and it can be cruel.
My instructor, he drilled it into me really well, how taking risks is just nothing's worth it. His instructional method was to tell me that when I jump out of the airplane, I'm dead. And this is how you can walk away from it. And say, if you listen to me and do it my way, you'll walk away from your jumps, you know? And it's worked my whole life, my whole jumping career.
So why do I do the sport? Oh, the people.
Yeah.
The people you meet. The friends you make, places you get to go with friends and people. So, you know, if you turn up on a drop zone and 119 other people will say hello and know you by your first name and have a chat to you, it's pretty special. So I have friends, not only, I always say that to people when they learn to skydive, that if you've got a parachute and you know someone, you'll have a bed somewhere in Victoria, you'll have a bed somewhere in Australia. And if you travel overseas, you'll always find someone that will take you in.
If I ever hurt myself or somebody else, I wouldn't be able to live with myself, so I'd quit. But I've never had to do that, so I'm lucky.
You do to me like lightning when I'm swimming in the sea. From the very first time we loved, from the very first time we touched, walking on wires and power lines, you put your body on top of mine. Every time that you lift me up to the heaven and stars above.
I'm begging you, please. I'm feeling drained, I need love. You charge me up like electricity. Jump start my heart with your love. There's an energy when you hold me, when you touch me. It's so powerful, I can feel it. When you hold me, when you touch me.
My name's Tyler Rogenbeek. I started riding when I was pretty young. I just enjoyed riding bikes around the house and doing monos and wheelies sort of thing, and jumping around, and then sort of just progressed. Adrenaline kicks in the most, I reckon, just before you jump on your bike and you're going down, you know there's something scary coming up. I reckon that's when you get your butterflies in your stomach and you get a bit nervous and shaky. And then once you're writing, it sort of just all disappears out of your head and you're just sort of in the zone and ready to go. The most rewarding part would be just riding with buddies, just going down the hill together, and then just jumping all the jumps and doing something really cool, and like all your mates does something really cool in front of you and you're all psyched, and then at the bottom you're just laughing and high five each other and just like, oh, did you see me do that? That was awesome, and so it's just a good time, I guess. I don't think I've had any regrets. Every time I've gotten on the bike, it's been fun. Crashing sucks, but it's all part of it. I have fallen off a couple times. I fractured my thumb. I didn't ride for at least 6 to 8 weeks. And in that time, my friends progressed quite a bit. And I struggled to get the confidence back to ride. I eventually just came back to it because I fell in love with it again and got back on the bike. And ever since then, I've enjoyed it a lot. Any regrets?
No. Life's too short to regret anything.
I don't want to be on my deathbed, have any regrets. So I'm just going to try and live life to the fullest and just keep on riding.